Hello everybody, welcome to What's Brewing with me, Pooja Talwar, and I'm bringing my guest on. She actually has been rather down, and so just bringing my guest on, it's Shreya Dhanmantri, and just adding her. So Shreya has been pretty active this lockdown, you know. She's acted and directed The Viral Wedding. I'm sure many of you have caught these, caught the nano series, micro series as I call them. So Shreya's our guest today, and yes, she's here. And she was in White Sheet India, and she also has a lot of exciting things coming.
Hi!
Hello! So what's brewing in your papa?
Actually, it's not a good thing that I should be telling people, but it's Coke.
It's
Coke.
Acha, after lunch you like to have Coke, is it? Are you one
during,
of those?
With lunch.
Acha, you're one of those, because ek zamane mein hum log Campa Cola lete the, Coca Cola.
Yeah, completely like that. It's just nice.
I know what you mean. It just makes it sweet and makes you feel good. So
yeah,
how's it been for you?
Need to have soda. Sorry, Pooja, tell me.
No. Soda, and you know, soda with nimbu and little bit of sugar is quite nice also.
It's quite nice.
I agree.
How
with
are you?
I'm okay. How about you? You're in Delhi.
Yes, I am in Delhi. I'm home.
Wow. So how have the past 5 months been for you? Because when you spoke first, it was, I think, the first month.
Yeah, I think so. I think Viral Wedding was gearing up for release at that point of time, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so... when the lockdown started, which I think was in March something, so I was busy with Viral Wedding till May. So I actually started living the absolute lockdown isolation thing from June. And then in June, I came to Delhi, and then I've been chilling with my parents. They're like board games, and there's food here all the time. So I'm just eating. I'm eating my weight.
Lagta nahi hai aapko dekhkar that you know. How
but
do you do
so
it?
Funny. No, I'm doing good, because it's so funny that when I was told that Pooja wants to do a live with me about nutrition and food, I'm like, shit, yeah, I'm like the worst person. Because she knows, I mean, we've talked about this, the eating and the food habits before, and she knows exactly how bad my habits are. I'm like, I don't know what I'm going to contribute to this apart from telling people not to be like me, basically.
No, but if you eat everything, as you say, if you're a foodie, it's good now. No food is bad, they say. In moderation, everything is good.
That is the key word. The fact that you said moderation, that is key. If people can follow that, it's great.
So what's been on your plate this lockdown?
Everything. I cannot tell you how much. Because I just forgot that staying at home, there's just food, yeah, Pooja? There's just food all the time. I just have to say I'm hungry, and then there's food. This is not something I'm used to when you're living on your own and you're single and just, you know, there's just food here. So that itself is like a bonus. So whatever's in front of my face, I'm eating. And mom's making sure I'm like eating healthy and all that, because it's home cooked food. But because it's home cooked food, it's just all sorts of everything. I just finished having like a lovely lunch of keema, mutton keema.
Wow.
Yeah. So, and before that, it's just like dals, different type of chicken curries. My birthday was like 2 days ago. Mom made chicken biryani.
Belated happy birthdays.
Thank you. So my mom made chicken biryani, gulab jamun, kaju barfi, badam barfi, chocolate barfi, and besan laddus.
Yeah. Wow.
I'm not making this up. This is true.
No, but it's good, na? They all say the desi Indian mithai is much better than your cakes and Western cakes and puddings.
We got 5 cakes and 1 cheesecake and 12 donuts also. So that's also in the house, because again, it's a birthday thing. So people kept sending amazing sweet things because I have a sweet problem. So yeah.
So do I. And they keep saying that sugar is the new cocaine. It's the new smoking. It's really got a bad rep.
I know. People say that, but I still feel like I do realize that sugar is quite dangerous, but to compare it to a cocaine, which is a proper hard drug, or to smoking, which is proper cancerous, seems a little bit intense.
I know what you mean. You know, there's something I wanted to ask you. Aapki industry mein birthdays hote hai na, wo log pose karte hai 5-5, 6-6 cake ke saath, और वैसे खाते नहीं है वो, केक जाते कहाँ है मुझे बताओ।
That I don't know because I'm eating all my cakes. I see that's even I understood that because I know a lot of people they don't. They really don't. I have those like I really have dessert cravings and I have that actual problem that I'm trying to work through. But you remember we spoke about it last time because I realized I can't exactly do the control thing on the food, so I'd rather have everything in food and then work out like a beast. Which I realize is not exactly healthy because I'm just working out so that I can eat, you
But
know,
that's also good,
essentially.
yeah. That's
Yeah,
also
but
good.
that's what I do. So, you know, I make sure that I work out and I know I don't miss a workout and I just don't just gobble it up. So we're taking it. So this is actually what we're doing. So because we have five cakes, we're taking a small slice of all the cakes and having it with tea, like high tea, for the past 3 days.
Awesome,
Yeah, me
awesome,
and mom.
awesome, awesome.
Yeah.
So what's a workout regime like? I mean, what do you do?
So now, because I'm here in Delhi, I don't have my weights and everything here. So I do high intensity interval training. And I make sure actually that I don't eat anything after, say, 8 p.m. in the night. That's one thing that's actually helped. I don't eat anything. I have a proper heavy lunch, high tea with the cakes and the tea and whatnot. And then, like, an early dinner by 8, 8:30 max. And then we don't eat anything. And the last thing we have is a green tea before we sleep.
Okay,
This is
so
something
that's what
only
you
me
do.
and my mom and my dad do.
So is it like intermittent fasting that you do till the next morning?
I think it becomes that. I don't actively plan that, but the fact that I have been doing that, I think it qualifies for that. Yeah, actually, I realize that because I mean I don't actively seek to not eat for 16 hours. But it ends up becoming that because I don't eat anything after 9, say 8, 8:30, 9, whatever varies. And by the time I get up and then finish my workout, it does end up becoming 14, 15 hours. Yeah, it does.
So, I mean, you work out on an empty stomach, is it?
I do,
This
yeah, because
is.
I feel like so that's the first thing I do as soon as I wake up, you know, finish all the stuff, get to the bathroom, come here, and then workout is the first thing I get out of my system the first day because I feel like if it's the first thing you do, you don't have excuses and you've accomplished something and you feel energetic. So I like finishing that off right at the top of the day. So yeah, it and yeah, it's on an empty stomach. It ends up becoming on an empty stomach.
And rave reviews you got for Viral Wedding. Uske baad we got Indian Matchmaking. I think that must have been inspired by your series.
I don't, Pooja, you're such a nice, like, oh my God, what compliments you give. Yeah, shit, yeah. No, that's not true at all. Indian matchmaking has been in the stuff for a long time. But yeah, we did get good reviews. People liked the concept a lot, and a lot of them have been coming up on similar veins. I do get that. So yeah,
Yeah.
that's also happened. What is happening,
But did you
Pooja?
watch Indian Matchmaking? What did you think about it?
Me and my mom saw, yes, and it's, I think it reflects the sad state of what the scenario is, right? I mean, we can laugh and point fingers and all of that, but I think isn't that what the whole Rishta Dekhofaing system is?
Which is true,
What did you
which
think?
is true. I actually, be honest, I couldn't sit through. After the first episode, I just put it off.
Really?
I just couldn't sit through it. It was just getting too much because everybody carried on and on. And I was like, why am I actually putting myself through this? But then the
Yeah,
suitable girl, the documentary was quite nice.
that's the thing. That's something I want to see because it's the same makers. I believe they did that before, and apparently it's a much nuanced view and from the point of view of the woman, right? Yeah, that is something I have to check out. Yeah.
So, I mean, as you said, na, Indian matchmaking is the sad reality of what's happening around. I was like, you know. You open the matrimony and you see the same things. You're seeing again, why do I need to subject myself to this? So I didn't. Maybe I'll watch it again since everybody has been carrying on about it.
That is true. Hey, I want to ask you though, how do you keep your skin so glowy?
Really? Now I just saw
Yeah.
some rude gentleman saying, Budia, Budia, Budia. I really want him to come up and show me his face also so I can give him to. People are rude, as you know. My
Genuine.
skin, it's okay. It's fine. I said, don't do
Oh
anything
yeah,
actually.
it's looking very glowy.
It's, I think, maybe the light here, but I don't do
My
much.
God. Take the compliment,
Honestly, I don't
Pooja.
do
You look
much.
so nice.
I eat sugar. I'm also addicted to sugar. I work out like you do, but nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing
Really?
else.
There's no like creams and face packs and aloe gels and the I don't know
Nothing
what.
of that sort. If I do it once, also if I put one of those sheets, but I'm not consistent.
I know, same here. Shit, that's so similar. I do the same thing. I'm like, okay, today I'm going to do skincare. And I'll put one sheet mask, forget about it for like a month or something, and then notice, oh crap, I have a sheet mask thing to do. I
Yeah.
think, again, compared to what we put our bodies through, Pooja, you and I think we're very blessed now. Because
Yeah,
considering
true.
the amount of crap that I eat,
Same here.
I should not
I
look
had a
like this.
macaroon last night. Macaroon and then I had ice cream. So, yeah.
See, one macaroon is very different from 5 cakes and 12 donuts.
And I also finished my birthday cake, so it's okay.
Oh,
It's okay. And when there is sweet, it has to be finished. And then I said, tomorrow we'll start with no sugar. I've also flunked my second no sugar challenge. So, I mean, that says a lot about myself.
I do that. You know, a girl I used to know did this no dessert thing for 1 month. Yeah, for September. And I was really inspired, yeah, and she was really sticking to it. Like, that's damn nice. Yeah, maybe 1 month is a little intense. I will do 1 week. Let me try for 1 week, no sugar whatsoever. Yeah, not in chai, not in anything, not even like preservatives and all of that. I'm like, okay, chalo. Okay, so I started on Monday. On Tuesday, the next day, the next day, I'm like, oh my God, there's like 6 days left. How the hell am I going to do? And I ordered something from just like off the of Zomato or Swiggy. Stuffed my face, so I
I
failed on the
know.
second day.
Same
Second
here, same here. And this time I paid for the sugar challenge and failed it also.
paid.
Yeah,
How does
paid. They
that
had this
work?
thing about online support, pay, get onto the app. They did everything possible, but I flunked it. Everyone else did it.
Shit.
Yeah, so I'm like that bad a loser when it comes to sugar. But it's okay. That's the only thing that's sweetening up our lives this lockdown. And but you come from
Yeah,
an
and it
industry
just
where
makes
there is a
life
lot
fun. Yeah.
of. Exactly. And there's so much negativity around us.
Ghee
Let's
and
eat
shakkar.
something sweet and be happy.
Correct, correct. How have you been keeping yourself busy all this while?
Doing all this, watching
Office.
shows, doing this, and interviews that and working out.
What is the that you liked? What is the latest thing that you saw that you
I
liked?
only watch Korean dramas.
I remember the
I
Korean
only watch
drama.
Korean dramas. So I watch It's Okay to Be Not Okay. It was pretty good. Now, so since I like the hero a lot, I'm now watching a second show, Love from Another Star. It's absurd. It's about an alien and an actress, but I'm watching it because they're just pretty people around me.
Okay, that's a place that I really want to go. Yeah, South Korea is a place that I really, really want to visit.
Same here. I had plans to go to Seoul this summer, but you know what happened? We are all grounded and at home.
You're also in Delhi, na?
I am also in Delhi.
Ah, nice. How's the family taking it then?
They're okay, everybody's okay, but you know, after some time, you start getting on each other's nerves.
Yeah, that's true. We have a board game collection here that keeps us busy. I
Yeah.
love board games. So I even emotionally blackmailed a lot of my family and friends to gift me that for my birthday. So now I have like in the Delhi house, we have like 61 board games.
Board games.
I'm not kidding. We just made a list
Really?
recently. My sister, yeah, really. My sister asked me to tabulate a list. She's like, we should keep a list of things that we have just in case, you know? So I'm like, okay. And then we started counting. It's 61, and I still think I missed a couple in the back somewhere. So yeah.
And what kind of board games are these?
So they're all kinds, yeah. But actually, you know what? I'll take you there. Would you like to see it?
Yes, please.
Okay, I'll take you there. See, unlike Bombay, I actually have space here. My God, yeah. I love that about Delhi. There's space in my life. Wait. Okay, so this is the stuff that I got for my birthday.
Huh. Wow.
See?
Oh my God.
And this is the stuff that I mean, have. Wait.
Oh my God.
See this? I've missed a couple of those in the back. So,
My God. I am so impressed.
yeah.
I mean, you still
That
have
is my
board games the way
collection.
I have books.
Huh, sorry?
You've hoarded board games the way I hoard books.
I have books also. It's
You
worse
have
than
books.
this. That's like
Oh, wow.
500. This is
Of
just like
course.
60. Wow. Yeah,
Anyhow,
complete
was this
nerd
there
house.
recently?
This is a complete nerd house, huh? Sorry.
Sorry, I meant have you? I mean, nerd house. I get to. I mean, I have my nephew's board games, and I have my books. And any interesting book that you've read recently?
Oh, wait. I will show you because I literally finished this book yesterday. If I like how I'm going on like a tour in this
Good,
place.
Dad. It's nice. Oh yes, how is it? Yeah, they keep staring at me from the bookshelf. I haven't picked it up. Is it nice?
Oh, I cried.
Arre yaar, I need
Proper
happier
cried.
stuff.
Proper. I'm like proper.
Oh, oh.
Tears and all came out. I'm like, oh damn. This is so like nice.
Cool,
Kindness
I'll pick
always
this one
makes me
up.
cry.
I just finished Kevin Kwan's Sex and Vanity, very bad.
Oh, really?
Very bad.
You finished, the trilogy is over, no? Kevin
Yeah, the
Kwan?
trilogy is over. Crazy Rich Asians, Rich People Problems, and all was okay, but Sex and Vanity was terrible. So avoid.
Why? Sounds like it's.
It,
Well,
I
sounds
don't.
like a title that might do well.
The title will do well. When you open it, you're like, why? I could
I
have
don't
given
know.
him three more options how to develop that love story.
Oh, shit. Then why
Yeah.
don't you?
I'm one of those
Is it.
people who thinks about alternative ends. Do you do that? When you watch a movie and thinking, no, it should have ended like this, when it's an
Oh, so
imperfect universe.
many. Not just endings. Even while stuff is happening. Like right now, I was watching a really funny film on Amazon Prime called Get Duped. It's damn weird. It's damn weird. It's damn funny. I'm laughing my ass off. But yeah, anyway. You should write a book then.
I was working on it, then I stopped. I'm a procrastinator. I need to get back to it.
You must, yeah. If this is
I
something
am the
that's
world's
lasting.
biggest procrastinator. Biggest.
Well, then you must find a way around it. Now that we have
So when I
time.
die, my tombstone will say, there lies the procrastinator. I'll
Actually, it'll be funnier.
procrastinate while in death also.
That's what I'm saying. Actually, it'll be funnier if the tombstone read, here she should have lain 2 days ago, but she took her time.
Good one. Good one, man. You should be writing a book. But you have authored one.
I am a writer, but I mean, yeah, I should keep
Wow,
that more
please tell us a
obscure.
bit about the book, yeah?
So this book I wrote again in the midst of our entertainment hiatus slash unemployment, where it always makes sense to sort of keep yourself busy and keep doing something, right? So I wrote this book like 4 years ago, I think. Shit. Yeah, 4 years ago. And I obviously sent out feelers, you pitch, and you give out the first 10 pages sometimes, first 15 sometimes, first 50, or the three chapters, depending on whatever they ask. And Lead Start was, I mean, they showed interest. They're the guys who published Asura and Ajaya. And they
Okay.
said, we are interested. Can you send us the whole book? And then I sent them, and they liked it, and it got published. And it got featured in the
Wow.
Hindu. So that was a good thing. I mean, not many people, I mean, it didn't do commercial sales that much, but it was critically reviewed at least. So that's something.
Awesome. I'm going to pick it up.
Oh, please. It's on Amazon itself. It's called Fade to White.
Fade
And
to
it's
white.
contemporary fiction. Yeah, please. And tell me
हमारे
what you
टीवी
think.
में तो
I'd
फेड
love
टू
for you to
ब्लैक
tell
होता है ना,
me.
फेड टू व्हाइट इज नाइस।
Exactly. It's a play on that. So please read and tell me what you think. I'd love to know what you
I'll do
think.
that. I'll do that. I'll order it soon after we finish chatting. And after this, I mean, you did the viral wedding. So what next? I know you have a series coming up, right?
Yes, I have a show with that I just finished with Hansal Mehta and Jay Mehta. And their
Hansel
Omerta
Mehta
just released.
scam.
Yes. So I'm playing Sucheta Dalal in that. She's one of the lead characters of the show. And the show is about, well, the scam of 92, which is the Harshad Mehta story, which Sucheta Dalal helps break.
So
So,
you
yeah, that
playing,
should be out
you're on
hopefully
our
this October.
side.
So hopefully that should be out on October.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
But talking about being on our side, what do you think about this nonsense that's happening, the negativity? How are you keeping yourself sane? I don't follow Twitter anything anymore now. And especially your industry is in the eye of the storm. So how are you keeping
Industry
up?
is always in the eye of the storm. Yeah. I don't think it ever is. I just wish there was more visible support and unity standing for a certain someone who's getting vilified mercilessly. Don't know obviously what happened, what the truth is.
True.
None of us do. So it would help if we didn't speculate and add fuel to a fire that is burning for someone else's agenda, you know?
Yeah,
So
yeah.
why just like either, you know, like if you have to say something supportive, or if you don't know anything, just mind your own business. Is that so hard? Is that so hard?
नो नो नोबडी कैन माइंड देयर ओन बिजनेस. एवरीबॉडी ने वो बहते हैं बोलते हैं ना, बहती गंगा में सब अपने हाथ धोते हैं. यहाँ पर
It's
इट्स वेरी सैड.
unbelievable, yeah. It's just unbelievable. I mean, I remember when I was younger and I used to see news readers and like say the BBC or even, you know, Doordarshan was a little anti-type, but you know, it's just the way they used to deliver news and they were in the forefront and they were so poised and it was so respectable and attractive. And I thought, okay, yeah, you know, that might be something I should consider doing. At one point, I'd even applied to the BBC trainee program.
Wow.
Yeah, but now it's just noise.
It's
It's
just not.
just
I so agree with you.
noise.
It's just so agree. It's RIP journalism. That's what they say these days.
It's just noise. I mean, you're not chasing after the truth anymore. You're just chasing after what will get the most eyeballs.
So I've been
I
told a lot
haven't
of
turned on a
times
news
do
channel, yeah.
interviews with clickbait titles. Now, for the life of me, I don't know how to generate clickbait titles because I haven't done it for 25 years. I can't imagine myself doing it again now. I don't know how to ask clickbait questions because sometimes you have, you know, everybody's not comfortable in discussing. I mean, you are public figures, but you don't want your personal life to be public. But
No,
wo
which
hoga
is
na,
fair.
clickbait. Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, again, the thing is, it's not even that you have to say something nowadays.
Yeah.
People can just make up whatever the hell and then come to you after the fact and say, oh, do you have comment? I mean, you don't even clarify, you don't even ask now. Say, I don't mind, even though it's clickbaity, like you said, but I don't mind if that's something that came out in the process and then they made like a whole brouhaha out of nothing. That is still after the fact, right? Not instead of go write and print whatever the hell you want and then come back for a quote.
Yeah.
Oh, this has come out in the news. Do you have anything to comment?
You know, so when I was doing news, I would find it hilarious when my news editor would tell me, "Acha, ye stars se zara ek reaction lao on this," and I would keep thinking, "But this person has nothing to do with this. Why would she want to react on this?" And literally, I would get that response, but it would be important, imperative in the news meeting to get a sports person and a film star to comment on anything that was happening, and everything that was happening.
Yeah, because I guess that's the most, again, noise making
And then
areas.
becomes the headline. Now Shreya has said this for this. Tuck, 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 tuck.
Yeah, I don't think
And
anybody gives a shit about what I'm saying yet.
then.
But yeah, I see what you mean.
I know, totally, totally. But other than that, in your industry that is so competitive with so much of stress on looks and, you know, appearances, how do you keep yourself real in the unreal world?
Well, again, I think with the few times that we've met and talked, Pooja, I think you know that it should bother me a lot more than it does, because you can see it doesn't bother me, which is why I think I'm sane. Because I don't know, I feel like because the way I approach it is, because when you tell a story, I mean, when you're playing a character and you're trying to find the truth of the character, I feel like, yeah, concentrate on the telling of, you know, the truth, you know, conveying the story, being. So all the looks and all of that come ho jayega, all of that. But if you're doing a good performance, if you're actually living the truth of that character, telling the story that you're supposed to tell, then it looks convincing. And when you look convincing, you look great.
Yeah.
Yeah, but unfortunately, in our industry, everybody's starting to look the same. There's
Except
certain
for White
ideas.
Club just ho gaya.
I don't know, it's a certain idea of what beauty is supposed to be like, so they all look the same. I can't even tell some six people apart. I really can't. They even talk the same, right? It's the same thing. And acting is secondary. Like, wo ho jayega. Like, it's supposed to be, like, I feel like it's supposed to be the other way around. Like, acting hai, okay, can this person do this? Can this person bring some intelligence, some curiosity, and some, you know, drive towards this? Okay, great. Look, karwa lenge. Here it is. Do they look good? Haan, acting karwa lenge.
Sadly.
I don't know. I think until we start focusing on telling great stories and using great people to tell those stories in every department, we are not going to be in the sense of world cinema ever, if this continues to happen. Looking at
Just
number
so
of followers, looking at a certain type of beauty, looking at your goddamn surname. We are never going to get there if this is what it is, the criteria is.
Which is so true because, you know, as somebody had said, it's also Tapsi also said, it's the audience that makes the star. At the end of the day, you go and watch that film, you encourage that new talent instead of going around after a certain surname, after a certain star. But that's the problem. It's the audience. It's then it comes down to the business, the producers and the studios. So you're right.
No, so in the sense, if the producers, or actually just take the example of certain names without naming the names, you'll know who I'm talking about. Yeah. They're constantly given opportunities, regardless of how their previous film does. Which again, I don't understand, because if your reason for not hiring new people or riskier people with no connections and legacies, then shouldn't the previous box office collection matter? But regardless of that, like, a few people continue to get chances. They continue to get chances and they're constantly presented in front of the audience. Do that same thing with anybody else and the audience will watch those films as well. It's just bringing them in front of the audience, like you said.
Yeah, I so agree with that. So a lot of people saying they like what you represent, your biggest fan. I don't know, actually, why people want you to take their name also, yaar. I mean, kitne logon ka naam lo. It's just like a roll call, yaar. Take my name.
I find that really funny. I always think of Destiny's Child and Say My Name. But that's a different context. But yeah.
Yeah, Say My Name, yeah. To the universe also, Destiny's Child. I mean, they also have one fabulous success story, yeah. And their song, I'm a Survivor, used to be the anthem once upon a time.
Oh, please, yeah, for sure. That was
so
like
what are you listening? 2000 and yeah, 2000, early 2000, no?
Yeah, I think there's Destiny's Child started from late 90s. No, not proper 2000s. I think so.
Yeah. So what's on your playlist? What do you listen to on loop?
I haven't listened. It's all the stuff that I've been reading and watching, actually. I haven't listened for long. But again, my go-to is actually metal.
Okay. Why am I not surprised?
You're not? Okay, that's
good. It
fits
in very well. It fits in very well. But okay, it's just always lovely to chat with you. Yeah. So now off to Mumbai and back to work.
I will be going next week. Yes. Because I have like a patchwork shoot and then probably I'll have to prepare for Scam releasing as well. So yeah, I will be going next week. It's so funny. It's very opportune. Otherwise I was planning to sit at Delhi and not go anywhere. But yeah, I will have to shoot next week. Let's
Are
see.
Are you really scared about being back on set, masks and...
I really am. But the major part of my tension is because I'm living by myself in Bombay. So there's no spread, you know, there's no risk of spreading it. Because here in Delhi, I'm living with mom and dad. So I wouldn't take the risk if I were coming back here. But because I'm there and I'm by myself, it's just me. It's okay. I mean, I will be safe. Not that I'm not scared, but at least I'm not, the extra tension of like infecting people is not there, you know?
True. My only thing is with the social distancing, my romantic films have gone for a toss. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know how that's going to happen. But let's worry about that when that opportunity comes.
Yeah, I know. I think now we'll only be making... I'm sure it's going to affect narrative. And now you can't have films without a mention of what we've all lived through.
I would imagine so. But I don't think people are doing that, surprisingly. Yeah. I think they're just going ahead with whatever was on shoot before. And they've taken this as a pause button. And then they're resuming it like... For me, it feels weird that you're not acknowledging such a big thing that happened. And like literally pause the world. How do you...
Yeah.
I don't know. True. But again, expecting like... That's so much from our legacy. Forcing kids to take IIT exams in this time. That sort of people, I don't know what to expect at this
I'm
point.
So with you on that. But anyways, lovely chatting with you. Please have a slice of cake from my side. High tea time in a few hours. Lovely talking to you, Yashreya. All the
Same,
very best.
Yeah,
and stay safe.
All the way. Thank you too. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Thanks.